the behalf of Professor Chandrika, I am reading our paper on Semyon Ludvigovich Frank. This distinguished Russian philosopher was born in 1877 in a Jewish family in Moscow. Frank, in his early days, was for a while a Marxist. Later, he was arrested in connection with the students' riots in Moscow and was forbidden to live in university towns. His involvement in revolutionary activities and ensuing exile delayed his academic career. During his youth, Frank experienced two ideological passions, Marxism and later Nietzscheanism. But the sectarian character of Marxism soon repelled him. In Nietzsche, he valued not so much the teaching on Superman, but rather the atmosphere of spiritual life. This acquaintance with Nietzsche awakened his philosophical interest. He became a philosophical idealist and then a Christian philosopher. In 1909, he took part in a celebrated symposium, Wiki, which is also known as Milestones, for which he published an article unmasking the spiritual nihilism of the leftist branch of the Russian intelligentsia. For a few years then, he was a professor of philosophy at the University of Saratov. But in 1922, along with the large group of scholars, he was exiled from the USSR. After that, he settled in Germany, where he wrote a number of articles, among them on religion and science, under Fall of Idols, dealing with the spiritual crisis of the Russian intelligentsia. The books by Frank included The Object of Knowledge, The Human Soul, The Methodology of the Social Sciences, An Introduction to Philosophy, The Spiritual Foundations of Society, The Unknowable, God with Us, Light in Darkness, and Reality and Man. Before moving further, it is important to describe Frank's philosophical development, as one can see in his writings the impression of different intellectuals. In the beginning of his career, he was powerfully influenced by neo-Kantianism, then the dominant philosophical trend in German universities. His first mentor in the philosophy was the maverick neo-Kantian philosopher George Simmel, whose lectures he attended when he was a student at the University of Berlin, and at roughly the same time he came under the intellectual influence of Windelband. From the neo-Kantians, Frank derived not just particular doctrines but the whole framework of his other philosophical thinking. They taught him what the crucial problems of philosophy were and what criteria a satisfactory solution to these problems would have to meet. Later on, he began liberating his thought from neo-Kantian assumptions, and in his struggle to define his own philosophical path, he was greatly assisted by the writings of several contemporary German thinkers who stood outside the neo-Kantian mainstream. In addition, he benefited greatly from his intensive study of the history of philosophy, especially the Platonic tradition. However, the thinker with whom Frank has the most affinity is the 15th century German Platonist Nicholas of Cusa. In his magnum opus, Unknowable, Frank calls Cusa my only teacher of philosophy. Of the various neo-Kantian influences on Frank's thinking, finally, he was intoxicated by Nietzsche's vision of a lonely elite of free spirits. Frank also gives the social and political philosophy, but the current paper discussed briefly is epistemology and metaphysics. Frank's first major work, The Object of Knowledge, deals with the problem of epistemology. He accepts here Lossky's intuitivism, but he develops the doctrine on intuition in his own manner. According to Frank, that epistemological realism towards which intuitivism leans may be founded only in insight into ideal, that is, the superspatial and the supertemporal foundations of the world. He argues the main condition of the possibility of intuition lies in the unity of subject and object and their participation in the wholeness encompassing them. Otherwise, the object of knowledge would remain transcendent and the world unknowable. Moreover, the world itself being thought of not as the sum of its elements, but as an organic whole. In both dimensions, Frank arrives at the idea of the unity of multiplicity, or pan-unity, as Solovyov terms it, which Frank developed with greater depth and consistency. So, analyzing the structure of logical judgments, he gives the unity of subject and predicate, which as such he calls is metalogical. At this position, he arrives in a very rational manner. So, pan-unity is a kind of metalogical synthesis. The idea which was to become the standing point of his later masterpiece, The Unknowable, which is the outstanding philosophical production of Franz's emigre period, in which he approaches the crucial issues of metaphysics through an analysis of the limitations of human understanding. He uses the terms unconditional being or reality to designate the total unity that embraces everything. Total unity is truly all-embracing, as much as it contains within itself both being and the knowledge of being. The total unity is being illumined from within. In it, being as something given or conceivable is united with subjectivity, with cognitive possession of itself. At the root of all being, animating it yet transcending it, lies what Frank calls the primordial ground. God for Frank is precisely this primordial ground, revealing itself to man as a though with whom we can enter into a personal relationship. Unconditional being in its turn comprises two aspects. On the one hand, objective being, that is, being as the potential object of abstract knowledge, as the manifold content which is capable of being determined by ideal concepts. And on the other hand, a substrate of sheer actuality or practicity. This substrate is wholly indeterminate, as such it may be described as existing potency. While objective being is illuminated from without by the light of knowledge, which has its origin in the primordial ground, and pure potentiality is dark, eternally resistant to such illumination. Therefore, man is conscious of a primordial foundation, which Frank identifies with a personal transcendent God. Considering that he places God in the category of the unknowable, however, when he uses the term unknowable, he means rationally unknowable, and God is fully capable of revealing to man some knowledge about himself, while at the same time making man aware of his unknowableness. For Frank, the relationship between man and God, this hidden life, which is called religion or faith, is the most powerful, influential and decisive factor in all of human life. So it can be concluded with the Berdyaev's words that philosophy of Frank is a philosophy of all unity, and he is a free and independent philosopher, and the religious element of his philosophy is not within the demands of some authority, but rather of an inner spiritual experience. Thanks.